Hey, Miss Parvati. Come for a visit?
Not today. Just helping this fella.
All the lights in town went out. Since then, I've had wild-eyed workers begging my guidance. I'm surprised you would go along with this action, Ms. Holcomb.
I'm not sure what the right and wrong of it is, sir. But leaving the deserters with neither walls nor lights would have left them to the mercy of marauders.
Let's hope walls alone are sufficient, then. Oh, inarguably. This town was a pustule on the ass of the architect. Metaphorically speaking. You took it upon yourself to decide the fate of strangers. I don't know whether that's confidence or arrogance. Either way, I'm fascinated. Wonderful! This is fantastic! Well worth all the sacrifices I... Wait. What the fuck is this? Is this... French? I can't fucking read French! It's a law-forsaken joke is what it is. French! Ha! I was so high and mighty, preaching to the yokels about following the plan, while fighting it at every turn. Well, yes. But I assure you, it was not for personal gain, only for the greater good. I've spent my life searching for the keys to unlocking the secrets of the universal equation that underlies the plan. I had hoped this book held some of those answers. I became so desperate, I even got myself assigned to this plague-ridden backwater to find the damn thing. All the time and suffering I've spent. Wasted. Please. As if my life should have no greater meaning than proselytizing to a bunch of feeble-minded wretches. Nothing could be more excruciating than discussing the true nature of reality with people who have no interest beyond their next Aetherwave program. But that's neither here nor there. What I need to do now is to find a translator, obviously. But to do that, I'll first need to secure transport. You have a ship. Perhaps I could make myself of use to your crew. Free spiritual counseling, someone to watch your back, not to mention a grown-up in the party.
I'm 28.
Exactly. I'm pretty handy with a tossball stick, or any blunt instrument, really. I'm also a passable gun hand, if it comes to that. I can usually talk my way out of conflict, though. Oh, I'm fairly competent at hacking computers as well. Fantastic. I promise you won't regret this.
Edgewater's gonna miss you. Folk here always had good things to say about their vicar.
Thank you, Ms. Holcomb. I'll be glad for the change. It is my esteemed pleasure to serve as your crew vicar, Captain.
Thank you.
had a question about your plan, Mr. Vicar.
Of course. The cosmos is generated and directed by the Universal Equation, also known as the Grand Plan. By contemplating the teleological order of things, one can achieve verity. Right. You had a question?
Never mind. That about answers it.
The last of them.
I don't know anybody who ever came out this far.
Thank you. That's the last of them.
Wow. You crossed them all off, like some sort of heroic accountant running down a list. Teach me your ways. What? You mean Adelaide's little congregation of nature-loving nobodies? I could not possibly be less interested in them. You, on the other hand, you were a sight to behold. If I had half your skills, I'd be the greatest outlaw the coast has ever seen. No. I insinuated myself into their company, see? I may have bartered them a few boxes of Adrena time, but yeah, I'm sure that's got nothing to do with it. I got kicked out of Edgewater on account of falling sick with plague and stealing some medicine to treat myself. I'd heard some outlaws set up camp in the botanical labs. I decided to throw in with them, seeing as I always wanted to be an outlaw myself. Instead, what do I find but a bunch of former workers camped out around a greenhouse? I couldn't just go back to the cannery, so I was stuck with them. I don't know. The vital processes, like, oh, you mean around these guys? The marauders wouldn't hurt me, they love me. I'm practically their queen. Yeah, must be my natural charisma. Why? Adelaide wants me... I doubt that. Nobody in that camp really cared about me. Wait, you're telling me he's got a copy of The Masked Marketeer? Why didn't you say so? I'll take my stuff and head on back, I suppose. Grace is gonna be glaring knives at me, so I've got that to look forward to.
We're not getting through.
Can't get past that armor.
We're not getting through.
Down they go. our survival. Nice.
I've seen you limping a bit. You all right, Mr. Vicar? Need us to slow down?
What are you implying? I am perfectly fit. My knee is just acting up.
There's no shame in being older, Mr. Vicar.
Thank you.
I'll keep quiet. Easy.
Down they go!
Don't mess with us.